Nigeria is not bearable anymore.
Migration to other countries is not the best for me.
In fact, I even regret for me to even born in Nigeria.
Oh, it cannot be and it can never be.
I think migration, leaving this country, is a lasting solution for poverty in this country.
Yeah, it's not a lasting solution for poverty in this country. But as for me, if I have the opportunity to travel out of this country, I think I will. Because nothing is moving here. No light, no water. Then what are we doing? Understand? And everything is so wrong in Nigeria. That even our people abroad does not even want to come home. So why won't you go and join them there and make life better for us? My sister, I will tell you the truth from my own bottom of my mind. Nigeria is not bearable anymore. I think we have to leave this country. Or may God even pull everything down. Understand? Make everybody start all over again.
It's a two-way coin. Now, migration is a process of people moving from one place to another. And people move maybe for economic or political reasons. That's why people move about. Now, some people can look at Nigeria as a state that's already collapsed economically. And say, okay, let them look for a place they can get a greener pastures by going outside the country, which they believe that if they go to outside the country, they may have a better living than stay in Nigeria. So, in another way, it can be a better solution to it. But there's no way you can abandon your country anywhere. I don't support that. But we have to look at the leadership system. That's why most people migrate to other countries. Otherwise, it's not the best way for us. Now, it is now our duty to also tackle the government. Because to me, the youth are not doing what they're supposed to do. They are not fighting maximally to make sure that they prove that they are the leaders of tomorrow. Now, let's look at the leaders of tomorrow. If you look at our working ratio, which are majorly the youth, the percentage is very low. Very low. And what are they doing about it? How are they protesting about it? Have they one day wake up and said, no, enough is enough? Okay, look at the way they came out to vote. Although there's a low turnout in this election anyway, the past one. But it still showed the interest of the youth trying to push their government forward. I don't like that. The youth have really want to show that, yes, the government is not treating them fine by refusing to do, you know, to participate in any governmental activities or process like election, whatever. Migration to other countries is not the best for me. But the situation we are now, it seems to be a helping way, a helping hand, maybe a roadmap to success to most of us. Because imagine a Nigerian youth living with below $1. You know, it's shameful. I mean, it's unspeakable. It's absurd to me.
Nigerian here is not a country that doesn't have any trust because they said that they are fighting corruption. And the corruption is increasing every day by day. People are dying in sovereignty, hungry, and so on and so forth. So if God has gone do it, then I travel out. It's very, very more better and far better for me. Because, in fact, I even regret for me to even born in Nigeria, to be an even a Nigerian citizen. Because of things, the way things are going on. Even in politics now, it's a do or die, violent killing, and so on and so forth. They say that they are fighting corruption. So Nigeria is not a place that someone can live with peace.
Oh, it cannot be and it can never be. Let me cite a case for you. Illegal migrants has constituted a lot of dangerous and economic imbalance in advanced countries. The country of the world, the advanced economy, the developed country, they've made their own sacrifice. They've suffered for the economy they are enjoying today. And the current government in Nigeria has been looking about the issue of illegal migrants, that they have to tackle it once and for all. That's why they are talking about economy diversification. And let me tell you one thing. I'm not subject to the issue of going to abroad to go and be a second class citizen. Nigeria is my country. The biggest country in Africa, the most populous black nation in the world. I cherish my country. I'm appealing to everybody, stay back in the country. A lot of opportunity. Abundantly, Nigeria is a great country. It's still evolving. Definitely the country will get to its destination. And basically, let me tell you one thing. The issue of illegal migrants is the fulcrum of what really happened about traveling abroad without necessary document that can back it up. And that's why you see a lot of deportation here and there. And that's why you see from Liberia up to the Ghana, the African country here. What's an embarrassment? The basic thing is that we are the government. So don't expect Mr. President Muhammadu Buhari to do it for you. Don't expect Yemi Osinbajo. Don't expect anybody. The lie begins with you. The essence that they have to do is look at education system. Everywhere in Nigeria, every part of the street, the money is flowing. It depends on your initiative and idea. God will bless Nigeria.